China's most disadvantaged areas are in and around the Qinghai-Tibet Plateau. Scattered across six provincial districts in Tibet, Xinjiang, Qinghai, Sichuan, Yunnan, and Gansu. Yet, at their farthest points, they are around 2,600 kilometers from east to west, and about 1,900 kilometers from north to south. These areas represent the last mile in China's mission to eliminate absolute poverty. Severe environments, frequent natural disasters, concentrated underprivileged communities. These characteristics mean that eliminating poverty is a huge undertaking. To improve the lives of the country's most unfortunate, everyone has to work together, from the government to the people. Success has been achieved. Miracles have been made. Satellites have observed and recorded all the changes from space. Satellite images show that Maidog County is surrounded by snow-capped mountains and gorges. The mountains act like a barrier, keeping moisture from the Indian monsoon current and outsiders out. This was the last roadless county in China. And this was a crucial issue.
I remember in 2013, the news report, the president asked our representatives, "Have you been through the road?" 你看，全国有那么多大事，但总书记还惦记着咱墨脱这条公路呢。这条路啊，说起来修了近半个世纪，修了毁了修，牺牲了好多老前辈。我爸是75年参加知青，来修这个墨脱公路。问题是修了一辈子路嘛，没到墨脱去过。心里当时是不想来，因为在内地也有工作。 但是老一辈他们对这个公路感情，我看比我们还深呢。必须得来，不来不行，不来很梦就那种断头父子关系那种。这条路走起来反正是泥石流啊，塌方多得很。Gao
Fan 1, an Earth observation satellite, provides near real-time observations at an altitude of 600,000 meters. On September 17th, 2020, it captured a mountain collapse.
Oh, yeah, 前段时间这里山地滑坡，整个路基都没有了。这是真正的路基，是这个已经冲到水里面了吧？上面的泥巴推一下，然后该垫的地方垫一下。我们是尽量让车子过得平稳一点。我们是每天都要来，泥石流大的时候需要半天的时间修复吧，就是让车子能过。
This could be the most dangerous road in the world. At only 117 kilometers long, it traverses 6 geological fault zones and more than 400 geological hazard areas. It crosses over the Yarlung Zhengbao River, stretching tens of meters. Crossing the river was once perilous for both man and beast. Over the years, 4 bridges have been erected. This rattan bridge is the oldest of the 4. No one knows for sure when it was built.
坡的路那危险的呀，基本上都是悬崖陡壁，稍微不慎一滑脚就掉到几百米的鸭子脏江里边去了。罗巴族门巴族最大的期望、要求、希望、梦想，就是我们埋托的有一条安全的路。
In October 2013. 50 years after work first began, the Meidong Road was completed. Crossing over many mountains, this road led Meidong toward prosperity. This tea garden is 1.6 kilometers away from the heart of the county.
These days, not just the road is open, transportation is convenient. We here.现在开始城市规划，现在家庭主要经济来源就是种茶叶。
给大家介绍一下我们雾族的绿茶。
As homes were built, more points of interest appeared on the map. Meidong, too, became more vibrant. The increasing complexity of road networks connects people and resources. This has resulted in a more affluent economy.In space,Satellites record an unusually long 9-month rainy season. Surging water caused by the heavy rain flows along the Nujiang Valley. Cultivating virgin land in forest may not be a good idea. The mudslides not only destroy crops, but also cause serious disasters. Once a village was washed away by the deluge. But in less than a decade, the scars between the mountains have recovered and disappeared.
我们想起甘蔗上山湾学步吗？学校这些有没有烤树啊？那边有没有火煮啊？这些之类的，走路大概要7到8小时，累是有点累，但是心里还是踏实的。前啊，这边地方，这个苞谷啊，这大豆啊，土豆啊，这些之类的。
Lanshanjia Zaoko is a newly introduced cash crop that has replaced previous produce. Forest restoration has helped the cultivation of cash crops. This provides 50% of the income of underprivileged communities in Nujiang Prefecture.
让这一片草谷里呢，它通风。我是第一书记，在村里代表着党的形象。我们的任务是搞好扶贫同扶志相结合的工作。我们村以前有6000多亩耕地，实施了4000多亩退耕还林，村民的种地面积减少了一大半。
The environment plays an important role in areas like this. People believe that mountains and rivers green are mountains of silver and gold.
时光不等人，我们要好好珍惜，活着的时候一定要有价值。
Over the past 5 years, China has invested more than 55 billion yuan in forest and grassland in the most disadvantaged areas. A total of 238,000 forest rangers have been recruited. They have witnessed the changes and benefited from them. Near 30 degrees north latitude, there is a yellow band. It is the most famous desert belt on Earth. On the north side of the Qinghai Tibet Plateau, there is the Takli Makan Desert, the world's second largest mobile desert. The sand its distinct red color and make the scarce water bitter and salty. The low quality water made life hard for generations of people in Kuping. Many people here have yellow teeth and suffer from gallstone disease. For thousands of years, water was stored during flood season for people and livestock during the dry season. In 2018, the government launched safe drinking water projects. Today, safe and clean drinkable water is available to every family. The water projects created new jobs. Plumbers. These well-paid positions, created for the local underprivileged community, were filled quickly. The water is brought here via an aqueduct, coming from a reservoir that was completed in 2018.
这个水库是科恩片几代人的梦想。我是2017年到这个水库来工作的，我负责那个坝前坝后的巡查、渗漏、检查，还有数据的采集。尤其是上面来洪水了以后，它冲下来一些大的木柱呀，或者是别的一些漂浮物，定期的要打捞。
From the satellite images, we can see new farmland. From a higher viewpoint, we can see the development of water projects. They have nourished the thirsty land. Hundreds of kilometers south of Kuping, satellites captured an incredible handshake at the southern edge of the desert. The people of Tsele moved home three times due to strong sandstorms.
野外环境实验，对，要结合在一起来看这个结果。3.1，3.1啊，就是用我们那个河南土话呀，你是为啥而来的？我是为啥而来的？
scientists have worked for decades to combat desertification. Fortuitously, they also figured out a way to help the poor in the desert.
Сазықта би затқа жаққағам, оған болса мен балығым жатып едім. Сон мауысын киносын бір күтіне қаптым. Ай, кино қаптым бір таққан кейін.
The stench desert cola is also known as the gold of desert. It only grows with saxual and red willow. Plants for combating desertification in the desert. This gold is truly a treasure for the people here. With the support of the government, more and more people have joined the fight against desertification. More handshakes are yet to be seen. Satellites are sensitive to the visible light from the ground. They track the changes of day to night, revealing a story of light. From space, we can sometimes observe unexpected patterns. This seahorse is part of the Yellow River. Not far from it, there are some black squares. They are traces of human activity. This is the largest photovoltaic power plant in China. It stretches over 609 square kilometers, which is close to the size of Singapore. A decade ago, the place was suffering from desertification. This meant that animal husbandry was unsustainable, and locals left. But after the photovoltaic panels were built, they returned. Photovoltaic panels turn sunlight into clean electricity. The electricity is then transmitted through high voltage power lines. Photovoltaic projects, sheep, and the electric network all provide jobs for the people here. Light energy is typical in China's central and western regions. Photovoltaic parks have been built and have created nearly 1.2 million jobs. In southwestern Sichuan, satellites revealed the sharp rise and fall of the Earth's surface, creating fragmented mountains and valleys. The Panxi Rift was the result of tectonic movement lasting 370 million years. The mountains have divided communities. Settlements are concentrated in small flat areas on the top of the cliff.
Now we start to climb up. From the mountain to this place, it's about 1/3 of the way.
The ladder on the cliff once worried President Xi.
去年媒体报道了梁山州的悬崖村，看到村民和孩子们常年在悬崖上爬藤条，安全得不到保证。看了以后心情还是很沉重的，也很揪心。下一步要继续把遗墟脱贫攻坚作为重中之重，有的需要下一番绣花的功夫，这都是硬骨头啊。
The vine ladder changed into steel ladder. Families moved downward. The people of the cliff village began to live a new life at the foot of the mountain. Some, however, chose to stay. This hotel is still under construction. Investment comes from local government and enterprises. Labo works here.
大家看一下，这是悬崖村古里大峡谷，然后这边就是悬崖村了，也就是我的家。
As a web celebrity and tour guide, Labo is hopeful the project will attract more tourists. Moving to a more livable place is crucial for people wanting to rewrite their fate. Over the past 8 years, more than 9.6 million Chinese people living in poverty have moved to new communities for almost no cost at all. The satellite found a fast-growing community by the Yarlung-Zhaobo River. The people are from the pastoral areas of northern Tibet, more than 4,800 meters above sea level. In the future, this super community will house more than 100,000 people. Northern Tibet, their former home, is equal to the size of 39 Yellowstone National Parks. It will return to its magnificent glory as home to the wildlife. Three River Source National Park is one of China's 10 national pilot parks under construction. Satellites have given a hand in its development. The Beidou Navigation Satellite System has helped Chinese scientists map the migration route of Tibetan antelopes.
他们每年五月份开始穿过青藏公路和青藏铁路这个区域，都周来回采完子以后，按照相对固定的路线返回它的栖息地。现在就是我们北斗的项圈，算第一次在我们国内给这个野生动物佩戴这个项圈。它的天线随时的发射信号，我通过卫星，他们给我们来传输这些数据。
Juasong Songnan Dajia, who died to protect Tibetan antelope, lives on in this land. Where he died, the Tibetan antelope was protected by another group of people. Lost foals are brought here to be cared for.
可可西里是我们动物王国，迁户之地啊，那不是可可西里保护谁保护呀？我们实在赚也钱，这辈子。 我们永远看着他，永远保护他。
At present, the population of Tibetan antelope has reached 300,000. The species has been brought back from the brink of extinction. Today, people share the beautiful land with the Tibetan antelope. At the junction of the Qinghai Tibet Plateau and the Loess Plateau, dry, hot winds blow, and rain washes out thousands of gullies on the surface. Before going to university, To Shouying returned to her primary school to join the students for their first lesson.
他可以说是在我们球路土生土长的，走出来这一位，这一位，这个女大学生，甚至像你这样子，压根儿都没读来几就不多，知道吗？就是村子里边可能会有很多人。 是不理解你的，就是感觉你一个女生上那么多学干嘛呀？就只能认识字，能把自己的名字写会就行了。最大的动力还是我父亲，他说的最多的一句话就是：不要骗自己。
In the past, education was often out of reach to girls.
At first, I didn't want to go to school because the路真的太陡了。慢慢的，就是有那个大的朋友在嘛，就是下雪啊，下雨都是他们领着上去这种。 现在就是很多，就是包括我的姐姐妹妹，她们都是很后悔为什么当时没有坚持。我频繁地听到他们在我耳边说，就是我要是当时坚持一下就好了。
Now, more girls attend Chao Lu Primary School.
只有知识装在脑袋里以后，它就像不断的增值了，不断影响你的认识。只有文化的扶贫，脱胎换骨。
The Chinese government continues to increase investment to promote targeted poverty alleviation through education and to block the intergenerational transmission of poverty. From space, we can see changes on Earth more clearly than ever. China's unique approach to poverty alleviation not only channels investment to human resources, but partners underprivileged areas with different parts of the country. Places that were once shadowed by poverty are now being lit up. One by one. The people in China's most disadvantaged areas now have new ideas. They coexist with mountains, forests, and lakes. They rely on science, education, and new industries. The once unfortunate now harvest a rich life. Nearly 100 million people have been lifted out of poverty. This is the largest and most powerful fight against poverty in human history. As a result, communities have left behind difficulties they faced for generations. For the first time in history, they are no longer poor. It was all witnessed by satellites in space.
在脱贫以后还要致富，还要走一个现代化的道路，我们现在正在这样的一个路程上。
China's most disadvantaged areas are in and around the Qinghai-Tibet Plateau. Scattered across six provincial districts in Tibet, Xinjiang,